Dear Mr. Pollock, I've been very mad about not returning your picture that you sent in September. The truth of the matter is that I've grown rather attached to the picture, and I hate to part with it. You can come closer because I have no microphone if you want. Come in here. It's me, Jules. Listen, Mr. Pollock, if you don't have anyone to sell the picture to, and you don't want it back right away, could I just have it, like, framed? And keep it until you sell it? Please understand, I'm not trying to use my authority as a business manager or extort a picture from you just because I work for a magazine or something like that. Naturally, I'll understand if you want the picture back. And I will send it immediately. Sincerely, Mary Wickware. You know, what we were interested in here is like all the things that are marginal. What you're hearing is the music that Pollock listened to when he painted, but it's all the bad takes. The things that got thrown in the garbage can by Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. Because they keep fucking up. See? So, stop the tape. And this is Pollock's fan mail. People actually sent him fan letters. You know, I was wondering today what happens. People send me fan mail on Facebook, nobody's ever gonna put it in a fucking archive, right? Dear Mr. Pollock, I wonder if I might ask a favor. Would you please write your name on one of these cards? And maybe dribble a few drops of ink or paint or aluminium or something on top of the card and then mail it back to me. I've been collecting these little cards for almost a quarter of a century. I have original sketches from Howard Chandler Christie, James Montgomery Flagg, Lion Decker, Auerbach Levy, Arthur Zeke, and Grandma Moses. Grandma Moses is a good one, right? And many more. And I would like to put you in my album. May I have that pleasure? Sincerely, H.M. Brand. P.S. I like your number 12 best. Dear Mr. Pollock, just a few lines to tell you that my 7-year-old son, Manning, couldn't get over your picture, November number 9. Frankly, it looked like one of his finger paintings at school. However, he insisted that I write to you to tell you that he cut it out of Life magazine and put it in his scrapbook. This is the first painting that he has ever cut out. He really has quite good taste, as you can tell. Especially because if you see the picture of his dog, the Cocker Spaniel, Snafu. He wanted you to have this picture in exchange for his copy of number 9, which he loves. Sincerely, Mrs. Helen K. Sellers. Got that duck. Then we also have a new copy, a new issue of A. Il Topo, which is where?
Here.
Ah, only one we have? Let me see, I haven't even seen this yet. We have enough to give them away? Okay, I'm ready now.